We're asked to add, and we have negative 13.7 plus 28.5. The first thing to recognize here is that the positive 28.5 will outweigh the negative 13.7, and therefore the sum will be positive. Now let's find this sum using the formal rules for adding signed decimals, and then we'll look at the sum on the number line as well. Because we have a negative plus a positive, we'll be using the rules for adding two decimals with different signs. Step one, we find the absolute value of both decimals. So we need to determine the absolute value of negative 13.7 and the absolute value of positive 28.5. The absolute value of a number is a number's distance from zero, and distance is always positive, and therefore the absolute value of a number is always positive. The absolute value of negative 13.7 is positive 13.7. The absolute value of positive 28.5 is positive 28.5. Step two, we subtract the smaller value from the larger value. So now we'll subtract 13.7 from 28.5. So 28.5 minus 13.7. We need to make sure we have the place values lined up vertically. Move the decimal point down into the difference. And now we subtract. We need to perform an exchange here before subtracting. So the 8 becomes a 7. And now we have 15 minus 7, which is 8, 7 minus 3, which is 4, and 2 minus 1 is 1. So this difference is 14.8, but step 3 is to determine the sign of the original sum. The sign of the sum is the original sign of the decimal with the larger absolute value. And because the positive 28.5 has the larger absolute value, the original sum is positive 14.8, which, remember, is what we discussed, because the positive 28.5 is outweighing the negative 13.7. Now let's take a look at this sum on the number line. To model negative 13.7, we would start at 0 and move left 13.7 units. So negative 13.7 is just left of negative 14. And then from here, because we're adding positive 28.5, we move right 28.5 units. Which takes us to positive 14.8. Negative 13.7 plus 28.5 is positive 14.8. I hope you found this helpful.